Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. So now we are going to learn that how in a galvanic cell the electrical energy that is being produced, it is related to work. And as we know that work is related to Gibbs free energy change. So let us see the relation between the Gibbs energy change and EMF of a cell. In a galvanic cell, as we know that the electricity is being generated, or in this case we could say that the chemical energy is being converted into electrical energy. So during the formation of electricity, the work is being done, and this work is being related to what? It is related to Gibbs free energy, and as well as it is will be dependent on the E dot of the cell or cell potential of a cell, then only the work could be done. So now let us see that what is the relation between all those things. The first is, since you know the electrical work done in a galvanic cell is nothing but the product of electricity and the cell potential. In this case, the work will be nothing but the product of the electricity, that is the charge, total charge, into the cell potential. So this will give us a work as W max. So now let us move towards the next one. But according to thermodynamics, we know that W max is equals to delta minus of delta G. In this case, the delta G is nothing but Gibbs free energy change. So in this thing, W max, which is equals to minus of delta G. So they have this relation also. So initially we have got a relation as where W max is equals to NF into E cell. I could state it as equation number one. And later that we have got to know now, that is W max is equals to minus delta G. So I could equate it, or I could mention it as equation number two. So if I equate the both equation number one and equation number two, what I could get is, from equation one and equation two, I got minus delta G is equals to NF of E cell, or cell potential of a particular galvanic cell. So I could write it as delta G is equals to minus NF of E cell. So this is how we have mentioned the relation between the Gibbs free energy change and the cell potential. Now let us talk about the another one. Suppose in this case, if the concentration of all the reactant species is unity, then E is equals to E naught cell. Because as we know that according to Nernst equation, E cell is equals to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF into log to the base 10 of product divided by the log to the base 10 of reactant. So in this case, what we are, suppose if the concentration of reactant and the product, the both are one, then the whole factor, that is minus 2.303 RT divided by NF into log to the base 10 of product and reactant, that is division of product and reactant, this whole will be zero. So therefore in that case, E cell will be equals to E naught cell. So in this case, if E cell is equals to E naught cell, then delta G naught will be equals to minus NF of E naught cell. So this is how there is a relation between standard Gibbs free energy change and the standard cell potential. So this is how we have represented what is the relation between Gibbs free energy change and the cell potential. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got an idea that is what is Gibbs free energy change relation with the cell potential. So thank you, and share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.